Some breaking news now. A top White House advisor, the counsel to the president, in some legal trouble this hour. The U.S. Office of Special Counsel, that is an existing government office. It's not the Russia Special Counsel. The Office of Special Counsel says counsel to the president, Kellyanne Conway, broke the law. The OSC Special Counsel, his name's Henry Kerner, says Conway violated the Hatch Act. That's a law that prohibits mixing government business and politics. He says she broke that law when she said this on CNN's New Day.
When the president endorsed Luther Strange shot up in the polls, tremendously by double digits. When the president endorsed Roy Moore, when he started to talk about Doug Jones, the opponent here, which you still don't want to talk about, but the president does, Roy Moore took a lead in the polls again. Why is that? Because the president himself came out and said he doesn't want a liberal in the Senate. He doesn't want a liberal Democrat in the Senate. He wants a reliable vote for taxes, for life.
You'd rather have an accused child molester than a Democrat?
The president also said something else that you don't seem to ever want to reflect, which is the president said Roy Moore has denied those allegations, and the president said you have to take that into account too.
CNN's MJ Lee is tracking the breaking developments here. MJ, what can you tell us about this complaint?
Well, this is certainly a significant development for one of President Trump's top aides, Kellyanne Conway, the Office of Special Counsel, a different special counsel than the one that we have been talking about a lot the last couple of months, as you pointed out, John, saying in a new report today that Conway violated the Hatch Act on two separate occasions, including in that New Day interview that we just heard. The other was in an interview that she did with Fox News back in November of 2017. Just to remind everyone, the Hatch Act basically prohibits federal employees from using their official authority to try to interfere with an election, to try to influence an election, or to impact the outcome of an election. They are allowed to do this in their capacity as private citizens, but they cannot do this in their official capacities in the administration, in the government. Now, as we heard in that soundbite from the CNN New Day interview, which is from December of last year, we heard there Conway was speaking against Doug Jones, a Democratic candidate in the Alabama Senate election. And very interesting, John, if you read this report, it goes to point out that Conway was standing on White House grounds, and that our colleague, anchor Chris Cuomo, on New Day, actually referred to her multiple times as counselor to the president. And in the Chiron, too, the report points out she was titled as counselor to the president. All of this going to show that she was certainly speaking in her official capacity when she was saying things to oppose the candidacy of Doug Jones, not allowed to do that. Now, the question, John, that's not clear, we don't have the answer to yet, is what exactly will happen to Kellyanne Conway, if anything. The White House is the agency that would take action, to take disciplinary action against Kellyanne Conway. The special counsel, Henry Kerner, said in a letter to the president that he's referring the violations to him so that he can consider any appropriate disciplinary action. Again, we don't know yet what Trump will do, if anything, in reaction to this report, which says that Kellyanne Conway violated the Hatch Act on two separate occasions last year. John.
MJ Lee with the breaking news. MJ, appreciate that. We'll reach out to the White House, to the press office, and Kellyanne Conway as well for their reaction. A couple of interesting points. Number one, it is up to the president to decide what to do here. That's the way this law works. Number two, a lot of people don't like this. A lot of people in prior administrations, too, don't like this. They say if you work for a Democratic or Republican president and you're standing on the White House ground and you're espousing exactly what the president says, what the party says, why is that against the law? A lot of people say this should be rewritten, but it is the rule. As of now, it is the rule. What's interesting in this complaint is, number one, the Fox interview came first. Then the complaint says she was briefed by the White House counsel about the do's and don'ts of the Hatch Act, and then she did it again in the CNN interview. That's one thing that's interesting. The other thing is that the Office of Special Counsel says it asked her to cooperate and to talk and to give her reaction, and that she refused to answer their inquiries.
This almost sounds like a quaint, old-fashioned White House scandal. I mean, of days of war. Look, I mean, shocking, there's gambling in the casino. Yes, of course, the White House is talking about politics. Specifically, she was advocating for or against a specific candidate standing on the lawn there. You know, I'm not sure that this is, if this was all the Trump organization had to worry about, I think it would probably be a pretty sunny day.
It makes you wonder also if this speaks to kind of a bit of a blasé attitude in the White House and the administration about norms as a result of, you know, serving a norms-shattering president. And that's how you get expensive flights by cabinet secretaries. That's how you get a $31,000 dining set at HUD. That's how you get the president himself and some of his family members who are serving, mixing the presidency with their personal businesses. It's a broader thing, and sometimes it crosses a legal avenue.
And it's not the first time for her.
Ivanka, yeah, sorry, but yeah. No, I was going to say the same thing. Yeah. Ivanka got, Kellyanne got flagged before for speaking on TV, telling people to go buy Ivanka's stuff at a moment when sales of the Ivanka Trump clothing line were apparently on the decline. So she has come, you know, under the scrutiny of these rules before.
Right. And what the rules are supposed to say, because she is standing on the White House lawn again, if you're watching at home, of course, the president's counselor agrees with the president when he gets involved in a political race. So some people are going to say, what is this about? But again, the rules are the rules. When she's asked those questions, she's supposed to say, Chris, or to the Fox and Friends host, I can't answer that question. I'm standing on the White House grounds. You know what the president has said. You can play what the president has said. We're going to Alabama next week or whatever. But she's supposed to stop. Will there be consequences?
You said that it's the president that has to decide her punishment. What do you think?
She was told last time when the Ivanka thing came up, when she talked in the briefing room about go online and buy these products, she was told, please don't do it again.
Yeah.
In this case, she was briefed between the interviews and she still did it again.
Yeah, I mean, look, I think the answer to that, in all seriousness, the answer to that is unlikely. I think if I were Kellyanne, I would try not to do it again so that I don't have this kind of publicity. But it is the question of publicity and not the question of fear of real retribution from her boss, the President of the United States, for doing something like this.
And for all the turnover, she has been a survivor. Now, she has stepped back into the shadows. She's gone back into the shadows a little bit, even from the Moore campaign. She kind of disappears and chooses her moments more. But she is, for all this talk of Jared and Ivanka being, you know, pushed down on the chain, Kellyanne Conway's still there.
No, she is someone who is incredibly loyal to the president. As all these people keep leaving, she is hanging on. She has sort of found issues. She works on the opioids issue. She's found things to work on. And she does do a lot of these TV interviews, and the president, you know, likes her performances.